Welcome back to Head Start. Private firms have been reaching out to survivors of Typhoon Odette through various initiatives and programs, and one of them is SM Supermalls. Joining us now this morning, we have its president, Stephen Tan. Stephen, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. Now, in every disaster, SM is quite proactive and present. You have several malls in the Visayas and Mindanao. Let's start first. How were they affected by the typhoon?
We were, four of our malls in Cebu were really affected. No, but luckily, all are superficial, nothing major. There were glasses that were shattered and ACP panels that were blown away. But aside from that, the malls are quite resilient.
Okay, so I'm curious, you have electricity in your malls?
No, we have to use genset fuel. So we have a business continuity process in place. No? So we were able to immediately get diesel supply so that, you know, people who seek shelter in our malls, especially like the one in Cebu, there are more than 1,000 evacuees, no, that stayed overnight on the night that the typhoon hit, no, Cebu. There were more than total. We have more than 3,000 across all four malls that seek shelter with us. No, they were able to charge their cell phone. We gave them unlimited Wi-Fi connection, and people also parked their cars in our parking buildings because of the flooding.
So that's interesting. At the height of the typhoon, the SM malls, in a way, double as an evacuation center. I mean, of course, not literally, but then you do have, you've made the mall into such a way that you can accept thousands of people in.
Yes, we have done that in several typhoons, even for Raleigh, for Yolanda, you know, in Marikina, during Ondoy. We've done that, you know, all the time.
Okay. And what is SM doing right now, considering you have many areas, you have Cebu, Bohol, and several other areas of the Visayas and Mindanao that don't have potable water, and many are hungry?
You know, immediately while, you know, these things were happening, we were already packing. We were already distributing. We distributed 5,000 Kalinga packs already. That's relief good packs, which consists of instant noodles, rice, canned goods, bottled water. And then now we are in the process of distributing another 25,000 relief good packs, no, in the Visayas area. But aside from that, last night we air flew four truckloads of bottled water to the Visayas area.
So let's talk about the bottled water. No, I mean, clearly it's very expensive to keep bringing bottled water in. So itong the bottled water that you've air flown, would you know specific areas, Stephen, that you've concentrated on?
Yes, in the, you know, barangays around our malls, no, they're really in dire need. And we have accounted that it's all over Cebu, in Consolacion, Lapu-Lapu, in Seaside, and in the city center itself. Yeah. Uh-oh. We went to we coordinated with the local mayor, the LGU, for identifying the ones that are really needed.
Okay. Is SM, I know that this is not the core business of SM, but will it be able to supply water, I'm curious, with it coming from the four malls? Would you have that kind of feature, considering your malls are very big?
Okay. We recycle our water, no, but yeah, the recycled water we mainly use for our genset, for our to keep our malls operational, no, so that we don't add up to the need of, you know, using water from the source, no. But aside from that, we have other malls naman that could easily, because we're all over, no, like we have gotten, like, for example, diesel fuel from nearby Iloilo and Dumaguete. So these are the, because we're accessible, we have contractors that could provide those services for us.
Okay. And what you're doing, of course, is you're distributing food packs all over. But are there innovative ways? Because clearly SM has the stock, right? I mean, your malls have the stock in Visayas and Mindanao. Are there innovative ways that the national government or LGUs can actually feed their residents without having food packs brought in? For example, just access coming from SM supermarket or the malls itself.
The malls are operational at the moment. Yeah, Because that's the first thing that we have to do to make sure that we are open, that we are accessible. It's not mainly for business. It's really more of a form of public service.
Because see, Governor Artiap said something interesting yesterday. He was calling on the agencies just to send them money because he said, you don't have to pack the food. This is for agencies, Stephen, and not for SM. Mm-hmm. The DSWD doesn't have to pack the food because they can buy the food in Bohol because the malls are open. That's what he was saying.
Yes.
Para mapilis daw.
Yeah, that is correct. That's why we partnered also with Red Cross, no? Across all 78 malls from Luzon to Mindanao, people can donate through Red Cross. Just go to our website or social media pages. If you are in the mall, you go look for our donation booth, which is just right beside the Bears of Joy booth. They could, you know, use a QR code or just deposit in the BDO. So that is straight going to the Red Cross Fund that we could easily help in whatever the city needs. No, this is not just for Cebu, but also for Bohol, for other areas that even we're not in.
And I think for all our viewers right now, it's important for them, Stephen, to understand this. If you are packing goods kasi from Manila, it takes time to send them to Visayas and Mindanao, given that you do have roads that are blocked. The schedule of the boats moving there, technically, it's once or twice a week. It's not often. So the practical situation is SM is technically pre-positioned goods when you think about it. Because SM is so big, you're already pre-positioned in these areas. Local government officials are asking for donations so they can buy the goods itself from the likes of SM that are already there. Are you seeing that, Stephen?
Yes, we have worked with, as a matter of fact, we work closely with Governor Gwen, no? She has been working with us in getting goods from the supermarket to be able to easily, you know, distribute it as fast as we can. So, you know, if we all could do our part in donating, you know, whatever amount it is, we would be very happy because only if we work together, we could recover faster.
Okay, let's talk about donations right now. So clearly the Philippine Red Cross is partnered already with SM. You have all 78 of them and 8 of your SMDC malls. That's a total of 86 locations. And where else can they donate in Manila or any of your malls? Because you do have shoppers that are already out for the Christmas season.
Yes, for the bigger malls as well. Now, we have also partnered with De La Salle University. You know, they've set up booths also. We gave the booths for free of charge, and they have set it up and for donations as well, no? For in-kind or in goods. No? So they could also look for that aside from the Red Cross booth that we have.
Tanong ko lang, Stephen, it's interesting that you are also donating in-kind, no, ang SM. How do you ship them? Are they always air-flown? Or do you use the Philippine Coast Guard? What do you do?
Yes, right. Now, it's very lucky that we have an affiliated company to go or Airspeed, which is part of the SM group, no? So that is easily accessible for us. I've been working very closely with Airspeed to make sure that whatever Cebu is needed, we fly them in. You know, we've done that, you know, 3 times, 4 times a day already.
Okay. All right. Anything else you'd like to add? And I wanted to ask you also about your vaccination drive. Maiba naman tayo, sandali lang. Vaccination drive naman ng SM.
Okay. We are not stopping. We are not stopping with our vaccination drive, even with this Typhoon Odette. No, so we have just inoculated 7 million citizens or Filipinos in our malls across the country.
Really?
So we will continue to do this as long as there's a need for that. We are ready also for the booster shots, no? So we're not stopping, Karen.
I'm curious, Stephen. No? I mean, I don't know if it's a priority in your malls for Vizmin, but may vaccination drive rin ba in your malls there?
Meron. We have all over. We did not stop that practice, as a matter of fact.
Okay. All right. Any last words, Stephen, you'd like to add?
You know, there's only one thing that I really request everybody is to really help each other. Let's all help together. Let's put in all our resources, because together we can do more.
All right. On that note, Stephen Tan, I want to thank you so much for your insights this morning. And for those watching, I think I want all of you to consider this. Number one is you need to donate to reputable firms. I've been an advocate of this. It's very difficult to keep sending donations, GCash, to groups that you don't know personally and that will give you no form of accounting. So there are many big companies, conglomerates even, SM is one of them. I've posted a few of them. ABS-CBN Foundation is one of them. That number one, when you donate cash, you are sure that it will get there. Number two, to donate cash to the LGU would be much faster and to firms so that they can buy the goods from there. I mean, I know that we do as private individuals, we want to pack, but then by the time it gets there, it may take too long or it might be too late. So these are some of the things you can consider. So thank you so much, Stephen Tan, as always, and to the SM Group, thank you for everything that you're doing. That's get